guys, thanks for joining me today in another video. So after a quick walk with my dog, I'm back in the studio to do another time-lapse drawing. And today I'm drawing an orca, again, but with colored pencils this time. So that should be a nice variation from all the pastel drawings I've done in the past week. So yeah, I hope you like it. And at the same time, I'm going to give you 3 tips you can keep in mind if you want to grow your Instagram account, as this is a question I get very often. How do you grow your Instagram? How do you get followers? So I thought it would be nice to discuss in a video. And I'm just going to give you the 3 things that I've noticed are very important for growing your Instagram, and that worked really well for me. At the moment, my Instagram is at 156,000 followers, so that's pretty nice. It has been doing really well over the years. So yeah, I'm going to give you my 3 tips. So I think the most important thing that you have to keep in mind when you want to get followers on your Instagram is to have a very attractive looking account and feed. And this is very important. When someone sees your post, they most likely will click on your profile and then have a look through your account and scroll through your feed. And if it looks attractive, they will follow. And if it doesn't, they most likely will not follow. So it's very important to have your feed look attractive. And in my eyes, an attractive looking feed is a bright feed, bright photos, colorful photos. If your photos are very dark, very fuzzy, very low quality, someone will think that you aren't very serious, or that you don't really want to put much effort into your account, and then someone will not follow. So to take good photos, you don't have to have a very expensive camera. You can just use your phone, your smartphone. I still use my smartphone for all my photographing and video taking jobs. So yeah, your phone is just okay. And then you can use the Instagram filters to adjust the contrast and the brightness and the saturation and stuff. And that really is very useful. And that's really how I do it. I take a photo with my phone and then I edit it in the Instagram filters. So tip number 2 is a very important one, I think, and that is frequency. You have to post quite often to keep yourself in the picture. When I started out, I posted 3 times a day, every day, which was a bit much, but at that time it worked really well and I gained followers pretty fast. And then later on I switched to 2 times a day, and now I'm posting once a day. But yeah, you have to post very frequently to be able to make sure people remember you. Because if you post once and then disappear for 2 weeks and then post again and then disappear again, there is a chance people won't take you seriously. And especially if you just started your account, you want to make sure to have photos on your account, because people won't follow you if you only have 3 posts on your account and then you disappear. So frequency is very important when you just start out on Instagram, and if you want to keep on being in the picture and keep on improving, of course, your photos. The more you post, the more you're improving with your photographing skills. So that's very important to keep on posting at least, I'd say, 5 times a week. But it would be better to post every day. And tip number 3 is to use hashtags. Those are very important on Instagram. There are a lot of hashtags you can use depending on what your post is about, you have to make sure that your hashtags are relevant to your post. So if you have drawn a cat, you can hashtag cat, cat drawing, cat art. And there are also a lot of art sharing accounts on Instagram that have their own hashtag, so you can look those up and then use those in your hashtags as well. But make sure to not use too many hashtags, because that will come across pretty spammy. I do that myself sometimes. Sometimes I'm really proud of a drawing and then I use a lot of hashtags. But yeah, some people say not more than 3, but I think you can use a bit more, up to 7 to 10. So when you use hashtags, there is a chance you will get in the most popular section of that hashtag, and then your post gets shown at the very top of the hashtag feed. So that's another way for you to get found on Instagram. If people look through that hashtag and they see your post at the very top of the page, they will most likely check it out. And if your photo has good quality, and if your feed then has good quality, they will most likely follow you. So it's all like a vicious circle. If you make sure to put a lot of work in it and you keep on posting very frequently, people will start to notice you. So please don't give up too soon. It takes a lot of work to build your Instagram account. Some people will be more lucky. So yeah, don't get discouraged if you feel like you're not getting followers fast enough. It all takes time. A lot of time. So yes, I hope you found this helpful. There are of course a lot more things you can keep in mind, a lot more tips when it comes to Instagram, using Instagram, but I chose to do only 3 tips because I will be talking for way too long otherwise. So yeah, I really hope you liked it. I hope you liked the drawing. If you are here from Instagram, by the way, let me know in the comments. And yeah, let me know what you think of this drawing. And if you have your own tips for using Instagram, for getting followers on Instagram, let them know below in the comments as well, because maybe we could learn from it. So yeah, I want to thank you very much for watching, and then I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!